Stay awake. I repeat, stay awake. How appropriate are these words from our Lord as we begin this morning Mass for our convocation of lay ecclesial ministers. On behalf of my brother, our main shepherd, Archbishop Bignoron, on behalf of my brother bishops who are here present and my brother priests, it is a blessing for the Archdiocese of Detroit to gather as people of faith with all of our lay leadership, Christian service coordinators, DREs, parish catechetical leaders, liturgical musicians, evangelization coordinators, pastoral associates, RCIA coordinators, and youth ministry coordinators. Isn't that amazing? Stay awake, because it gets better. Stay awake. This is what we hear positioned at the very end of the eschatological discourse of our Lord, as is written in the Gospel of Matthew. Our Lord is preparing his people. You know, the Greek word of stay awake is gregoreite, which means be vigilant, be alert. And that's precisely the Christian meaning of the name Gregory. Do we have any Gregories in the house? We do. Very good. The name means be vigilant, be alert. And perhaps we might ask the question, to what? What is clear in the Gospel of Matthew is that we must be vigilant of the signs of God at work in our world. Today, as people of faith in this Archdiocese of Detroit, we are called to see the signs of God in our midst. God continues to reveal his will in our church. Today, we will have the opportunity to deepen our understanding of what it means to be vigilant and to be alert. To be vigilant and to be alert of the wonders and the signs given to us by the fruit of Synod 16. Unleash the gospel. The pastoral letter from Archbishop Alan Vigneron clearly states, Synod 16 was an occasion for representatives from every part of the archdiocese to listen to each other and to discern together the signs of the times. In Southeast Michigan, in the half century since Second Vatican Council, we have been responding to the Council's call for lay participation in the life of the church. We are ready now to build on that foundation. Yes, my brothers and sisters, yes, we are. Your active participation as lay leaders in our church is essential and foundational as we move into the new evangelization. We must continue to be aware of the signs God has given us in our Church of Detroit. We must be vigilant and alert of his presence in our church today. This is what we proclaim as joyful missionaries, disciples of our Lord. Today, we embark in this journey together. May our convocation be a sign of unity and strength. Following the practical wisdom of Pope Francis, you know, he's clear and to the point, and we all know that. Well, he tells us, first of all, that as we move into this new evangelization, in his letter of Evangelii Gaudium, he gives us five practical steps that we must take as joyful missionaries of our Lord. And as I go around the Archdiocese of Detroit celebrating masses, giving workshops, perhaps to some of our lay leadership, I always remind them of these five simple steps. Step number one, you take the step. That is simple, right? Yes, that's what we need to do. You take the step. That's step number one. You can do it. Then he says, step number two, you are engaged with our people. To engage with our people is just not only to say hi and bye. To engage with our people, especially here in the Archdiocese of Detroit, is to acknowledge their presence. To acknowledge that we are a church, that we can see them. That is to engage. That's the step number two, my brothers and sisters, my lay leadership, that we must take. And now, step number three. This is the one that takes time and courage. Step number three is we must accompany our people. So we take the first step. We say, hello, I can see you, you're there. Now, I want to walk with you. I want to be with you. I want to be part of your story. I want to hear of your dreams. I want to share your joys and your sorrows. Whatever you are in life, I'm here with you. That is to accompany someone. That is what it means to be a joyful missionary disciple. Step number four, we must bear fruit. In bringing about the good news of our Lord, as we stay awake and be alert and vigilant of the signs of the times in our church, we accompany our people and we bring fruit. The fruit is that encounter with our Lord. That He is the one that we bring. He is the one that calls us to be one with our people in our church. So fruit will come from our experience, our engagement, our company with our people. And for those who are taking notes of my preaching, I'm moving into Roman numeral 5. Step 5. We celebrate. That's what we do. As people of faith, as joyful missionary disciples, as joyful leadership here in the Archdiocese of Detroit, we celebrate God's presence in our lives. I have no doubt that the most effective way to transmit the truth of the gospel is by the joy that we bring to it. But a simple smile to our brothers and sisters, so please keep smiling, stay awake. It's gonna be a long day before you. That's what a joyful disciple does. We take the first step, we engage, we accompany, we bear fruit, and we celebrate. And he said, that's what we're doing today. Please say yes. 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 I would like to echo the words that we hear in today's reading from St. Paul as he writes to the first Christian communities of Thessalonica. Now may God himself, our Father, and our Lord Jesus direct our way to you. And may the Lord make you increase and abound in love for one another and for all, just as we have for you, so as to strengthen your hearts to be blameless in holiness before our God and Father at the coming of our Lord Jesus with all his holy ones. Amen.